The advanced calculated data function was added in order to expand the possibilities of doing calculations using data link. In the standard calculated data function, there were certain things you couldn't do, such as time-weighted calculations or using filter expressions. Those functions have been added to the advanced calculated data dialog box. And in fact, the new features are these four. You are allowed to use filter expressions or filtering. The expression sampling options have been added. I'll explain those in a moment. You can do event-weighted or time-weighted calculations. The calculated data dialog box only does time-weighted calculations. And you can define a minimum percent good values. So if the minimum percent good does not meet the threshold, the calculation will not be run. Let's take a look at the dialog box. First, I'd like to demonstrate how the minimum percent good works. Let's use our CDT158 and go back over the last 8 hours. Looking at 1 hour intervals, I want to calculate an average. However, I only want to do it if my percent good is over 80%. I'll click OK, and you can see that I have one line item here where I have insufficient good data. I did not meet the threshold. In the advanced calculated data dialog box, it would have simply used the values that were available and reported a result to me. Let's also look at something that we can do now more meaningfully in the advanced calculated data dialog box, and that is event-weighted calculations. These are things like counts, where you only want to evaluate for the specific events in the archive, and you don't want to figure out a time weighting for the function. You just simply want to use the actual events that are in the archive. So let's go and look at tag name, and over the last 8 hours, start time 8 hours ago, end time now. And I am going to put my calculation mode in count, and I'm going to do an event-weighted calculation. And you can see that I have 93 events in the archive over the last 8 hours for my CDT158 tag. So that is an event-weighted count. If I would have done that as a time-weighted count, it would have tried to expand over that many seconds over the 8 hours, and basically I would have counted once for every second. So time-weighted counts don't make much sense. However, event-weighted counts make a lot of sense if you want to know how many values you've recorded over that period of time. I'd also like to point out expression sampling options. If you have a tag name and you have an expression here, let's see, I have tag name CDT158, and my filter expression is tag 1 is greater than 5. My sampling options are point compressed, expression compressed, and interpolated. If I select point compressed, it's going to evaluate and return a value to me every time my source tag has a value in the archive. If I select expression compressed, it's going to return a value to me not every time the tag has a value in the archive, but every time any or all of the tags in the filter expression have an event in the archive. So we will evaluate based on those events, not the source tag events. And if I say interpolated, it will ignore the events in the archive and use my expression sampling frequency to evaluate the results. So depending on what you pick for expression sampling, if you have a filter expression, that's the number or the quantity of the results you're going to get.